Dell Publishing released their second comic book title in late 1936. The Funnies number one debuted. It was published to rival Eastern Color's successful comic book series called Famous Funnies. It similarly reprinted newspaper comic strips, mostly NEA syndicate comics, such as Alley Oop by V.T. Hamlin and Captain Easy by Roy Crane. Packaged by Max Gaines and editor Sheldon Mayer, it ran 64 issues from 1936 to 1942. It began running original material in issue number 2 with Sheldon Mayer's feature Scribbly about a boy cartoonist. Other original strips would eventually start popping up. The Funnies number 1 features the first comic book appearances of Alley Oop, Captain Easy, and others. There is a Lamont Larson pedigree copy of this book that grades 7.5. The debut issue of the series featured 37 different strip titles, mostly with a length of one page each. James Robert Williams was born March 30, 1888 in Nova Scotia, Canada, and lived until June 17, 1957, a cartoonist who signed his work J.R. Williams, best known for his long-run, daily syndicated panel, Out Our Way. As noted by Colton Waugh in his 1947 book, The Comics, anecdotal evidence indicated that more Williams cartoons were clipped and saved than other newspaper comics at the time. Out Our Way first appeared in newspapers on March 20, 1922, with 40 million readers by 1930, appearing in more than 700 newspapers at its peak. Edgar Everett Marden, born July 6, 1898, lived until August 31, 1960. Known to his family and friends as Abe Marden, he was an American cartoonist who kept his comic strip Boots and Her Buddies running for decades, eventually reaching an audience of 60 million readers. Syndicated by NEA, it appeared in 500 newspapers during the 40s, with about half that carrying the Sunday strip. In the post-World War II years, the figure climbed to 700 newspapers. Gladys Parker, born 1910, lived until April 28, 1966, an American cartoonist for comic strips and a fashion designer in Hollywood, best known as the creator of the comic strip Mopsy, which had a long run over three decades. Parker was one of the few female cartoonists working in the 30s and 40s. Developing Mopsy in 1939, she modeled the character on herself. By the end of the 40s, Mopsy was published in 300 newspapers. In 1947, Mopsy began in St. John Publications' Pageant of Comics No. 1. 2 years later, St. John gave her a title of her own, and Mopsy ran for 19 issues from 1949 to 1953. Charlton Comics eventually would reprint some of those issues in 1951. And in 1955, Berkeley Books published a Mopsy paperback collection. The Funnies number 2 featured many of the popular newspaper strips from number 1, as well as Scribbly. Scribbly Gibbet, the boy cartoonist written and drawn by Sheldon Mayer, received his own title in 1948 after years of appearances, first in The Funnies and then eventually over at DC in All American Comics and Comic Cavalcade. Scribbly ran regularly in The Funnies, starting with issue number 2. Bella Zaboli. and he was the longtime artist of Western hero Tom Mix's comic books. In 1935, Fufer and writer Bob Moore created a sci-fi adventure comic strip titled Don Dixon, which became more and more popular over the years. Fufer's first Submariner art for Marvel Comics was Marvel Mystery Comics number 32 in 1942. He also drew many issues for Timely, including Submariner Comics, All Winners Comics, All Select Comics, Captain America Comics, and Blonde Phantom Comics up to 1948. Dell Comics was also associated with a four-issue free giveaway series in 1936 titled Butterfly Comics. 8-page issues printed in a standard modern comic book size, newsprint and saddle stitched. The giveaway was sponsored by Butterfly Bread, reprinting popular comics such as Smokey Stover, Tailspin Tommy, The Gumps, plus Red Magic, a novelty feature by A.W. Nugent. These are extremely rare. Knock Knock was a one-shot release from Dell Comics in 1936 with a 10-cent cover price. Color cover with black and white interior. The dimensions were 8 by 9 3/4. Card stock and saddle stitch. The one-shot featured Enoch Knox by Bobby Dunn.